to aesthetic tutorials. My name is Lionella. I'm Director of Product and Technology at FXG. And I'm here to do a Nreal tutorial on hardware operations. So let's talk about what will be in this tutorial. We'll talk about the specs of the Nreal developer kit. We will talk about what comes in the developer kit box and any other things that I can think of at the moment. My developer kit comes like this. Your box might not come like that. Your box will probably look a lot better. Now let's see what's in the box. You have glasses. With a USB-C wire. And a computing unit. And this is the controller. Let's talk about the glasses. They're 88 grams, really light. Don't mind your face like this. And then this side plugs into the computing unit. Now it's important to plug in the computing unit after you turn on the computing unit. So you'll see that the light, right now it says it's loading. You can see that. You see different colors while it's loading. This is if you haven't already updated to the new version of the Nreal SDK 1.2. We will cover that in the next tutorial. Now you see that it's solid green. That means it's ready to be plugged in. You plug it right in. You can put the computing unit in your pocket, or you can leave it with the controller and then use the controller to move it around. Let's talk more about the glasses. It's 52 degrees field of view, and it has spatial audio. There's a microphone here and right here. And then there's also the speakers right here and right here. The nose piece can be changed out and it just pops right off like this. Just pull it off. There's different nose pieces. You can also attach special lenses so you can tell Nreal the prescription of your lens, and then you get them as these cool little magnets that you attach right on here, and it just comes right off the lens. There's also two buttons on the sides, here and here. The one that's on the same side as the Nreal is the one that controls the brightness. And the way I remember it is because the glasses are called Nreal Light, so this side controls the light. And then this side controls the audio. So if you press, see it's facing this way, you press down and then you lower the volume, up you increase the volume. And same thing goes for the light. So up increases light, downwards decreases the light. If for some reason you experience discomfort while you're wearing the glasses and observing an experience, probably because you're in a dark room and the brightness of your screen is too high. That happens all the time no matter what you do. That's why they always say, make sure you're watching TV in a bright lit room. So it's the same thing that goes with the glasses. If you're feeling discomfort, just make sure that you're in a room that has a well-lit environment, and that, or you can try lowering the contrast brightness of your glasses. Let's talk about the computing unit. has 3 DOF controller. We are also working with a company that makes a 6 DOF controller, and that will be more interesting to play around with. But this is very small and very light, and it's like a little puck. It has an LED light on top right here. That's how you know that it's on. So you turn it on by this little button here. Right there. This is how it charges with the computing unit. It's placed right on here. And it's like, it's also magnetized, so it clicks right in place. Now let's turn on the controller. So you flip the switch up. Now you'll see that it's green. And then you press and hold the top of the controller, right where the LED light is, and you'll also see this little pointer here. Hold it enough that it turns green. Just a couple seconds. It'll blink for a few seconds and then it'll turn solid green. That means that it's completely connected with your computing unit. Let's go back to the glasses for a second. The glasses don't have any power, so it gets all of its power from the computing unit. Glasses also have 1080p per eye, so the resolution is actually really crisp. There's a sensor right here in the middle that detects whether someone is using it or not. And the way that you know that your glasses went into sleep mode is because you'll look at the computing unit and you see how the light is blue now in the middle. That means it's in sleep mode. So you would just press this button right here one time and it turns back on. If you unplug your glasses from the computing unit, it will also go to sleep. It really helps with saving battery. The glasses also have SLAM, which is also known as simultaneous localization and mapping. It also has 6 degrees of freedom. So they can be used this way, up and down, this way, this way. It also does plane detection and image tracking. The controller is 23 grams and it has 3 degrees of freedom. So it does this and this. It's also touch sensitive and has haptic feedback. Let's put that aside and talk about the computing unit itself. Inside, it has a Qualcomm Snapdragon 845. It runs on an Android operating system. So technically, if you do have a phone that's at least a 845, then you could potentially use it. But you have to look into the other specs as well. The Nreal SDK also works with Unity, and it will work with Unreal in the future. There are 2 packages that will be available. One is currently available, that's the developer kit. That's what you'll see now, but in a nicer box. That one will be $11.99. You can pre-order it now on the Nreal website at nreal.ai. Another package that will be available in the near future is the consumer kit, and that will be $4.99, and it'll be available early this year. What is the difference? You will be only getting the glasses that comes with the USB-C wire. And the reason for that is because it'll work with your phone. Granted that you have the correct specs that are similar to the computing unit. Which is great because the whole phone screen will be a screen of its own that you can also use for your experiences. Right now we only have the controller and there's no LCD screen on here. But with your phone, you'll be able to extend your mixed reality experience by also utilizing the phone. And that's it for our operations tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think in the comments below. My name is Lionella. I'm Director of Product and Technology at FXG, and I'm here to make your Nreal tutorials. Stay tuned for the next Nreal tutorial, and I hope I see you again soon. Thanks.